In today's question, a client with myocardial infarction is developing cardiogenic shock. Because of the risk of myocardial ischemia, for which of the following should the nurse carefully assess the client? Option A, bradycardia. Option B, ventricular dysrhythmia. Option C, rising diastolic blood pressure. Option D, falling central venous pressure. Before answering this question, you must have a clear understanding of the concepts involved in this question. Let's review the strategic keywords cardiogenic shock and myocardial ischemia. Cardiogenic shock is a condition in which your heart suddenly can't pump enough blood to meet your body's needs. The condition is most often caused by a severe heart attack. Cardiogenic shock is rare, but it's often fatal if not treated immediately. Classic signs of cardiogenic shock include low blood pressure and tachycardia. The central venous pressure would rise as the backward left ventricular failure becomes more apparent. Dysrhythmias commonly occurred as a result of decreased oxygenation and severe damage to greater than 40% of the myocardium. Myocardial ischemia occurs when the blood flow to the heart muscle is obstructed by a partial or complete blockage of a coronary artery by a buildup of plaques. As a strategy to answer this question, use the process of elimination and focus on the strategic words myocardial ischemia. Recall that ischemia makes the myocardium irritable, producing dysrhythmias. Now that you have a clear understanding of the concepts involved in this question, you should be able to answer it correctly. Knowing how poor blood circulation affects the heart is key to help you eliminate incorrect options. Because of the risk of myocardial ischemia, the nurse should carefully assess the client for ventricular dysrhythmia. If you answer B, your answer is correct. Review the clinical manifestations associated with cardiogenic shock if you had any difficulty with this question. Thanks for watching, and remember to keep reviewing as many questions as you can.